Hi, my name is Kevin Chen. I'm the product manager from Keysight Technologies. In this video, I will introduce you the digital video broadcast for satellite-related technologies, focusing on the second generation card DVB-S2 and its extension DVB-S2X. Then I will introduce you the Keysight test solution for DVB-S2X and then give you a quick demo for our solution. Digital video broadcasting for satellite was firstly introduced in 1994 by ETSI. It just uses single carrier QPSK modulation with a fixed ROF at 0.35. The initial purpose for DVB-S is for transmitting the MPEG stream for standard TV. In 2005, there's an evolution for the second generation of DVB-S called DVB-S2, in which it can support HDTV service plus the internet access. It adds more modulation format as 8 PSK, 8 16, 32 APSK, and more roll-off factor support. It adds two-layer channel coding with LTPC for intercoding and BCH for autocoding. DVB-S2 has an extension version as DVB-S2X standardized by ETSI in 2014. It adds 116 combination of mode cord as a combination of modulation and code rate. It can support more shape roll-off factors and support channel bonding up to 3 channels. For the surface, it adds ultra HDTV support and support very low SNR operation. DVB-S2 is the mainstream on market now, but with a more interactive broadband data service is demanding. DVB-S2X will be widely deployed in the following. In this page, it shows you the DVB-S2 function block diagram and how DVB-S2X is updated based on DVB-S2. Firstly, you can see at baseband, DVB-S2X has the update for high efficiency mode support. In FEC encoding, DVB-S2X has more coding rate and add more modulation tab as 64, 128, and 256 APSK to support higher reach transmission. DVB-S2X also supports sharper roll-off factor, lower to the 0.05, and it adds an option for physical layer frame to support very low SNR operation. At last, it can support the channel bonding up to 3 channels. Then, let's take a look at physical layer framing. On top of the picture, you can see DVB-S2X begin with the PL header section, which uses the half-pi BPSK modulation for robust. In this section, the first part is called SOF, start of frame, which includes 26 symbols, and then follow with the PLS code as 64 symbols, which only transmits 7 bits for the mode card and type information. After the header part, it follows the payload section, which can select the modulation for QPSK, 8PSK to 256 APSK. There could be pilot block after every 16 payload slots. Each slot is fixed at 90 symbols. DVB-S2X has an option to support the very low SNR operation. In the physical layer frame, it adds the VLSNR header, which is 10 slot length and also uses the half-pi BPSK modulation. DVB-S2RS2X testing is similar to its previous DVB-S. There are 3 scenarios by the different testing cases as component test, receiver test, and transmitter test. For different test cases, there need specified test equipment and measurement requirements. For component test, it could be power amplifier or satellite transponder, and it needs both source and analyzer for the testing. The source can be coded or encoded because it is mainly interested with RF performance. The measurement includes both power measurement and modulation analysis like EVM measurement. Receiver tests such as set-top box or VSAT may need the fully coded source because it needs the BER, bit error, or FER frame error measurement. The transmitter just needs an RF analyzer and focus on the power and modulation analysis measurement. Let's see what kind of equipment and measurement Keysight can provide you for DVB-S2 measurement. For component test, the RF frequency can go up to KUK of V-band, and the required bandwidth for single carrier can be up to 500 MHz, and multi-carrier can go up to 2 GHz. Keysight recommends the X-series analyzer UXA, PXA, MXA, which can support 510 MHz and up to 50 GHz for single carrier measurement. And latest UXA N1942B can support up to 2 GHz bandwidth for multi-carrier measurement. M9384B VXE as signal source, which can support up to 2 GHz and frequency up to 44 GHz. It also supports two-channel configuration, so it's possible to generate two RF channels and combine them together, or use one channel for signal generation and one channel for the interference. For the DVB-S2X signal generation, you can either use N7608C for generating uncoded DVB-S2X signals, or use N7623C for generating the coded DVB-S2X signals. 89600 VSA software with option 89601 AYAC or 9N9054 EM0E VMA digital modulation application can measure DVB-S2 signal with power and modulation analysis. For receiver test, it just needs a signal source with fully coded DVB-S2X waveform. The signal generator can be MXE N5182B with bandwidth up to 160 MHz and RF frequency up to 7 GHz. Or you can choose the IM9384B VXE with bandwidth 500 MHz or up to 2 GHz with RF frequency up to 44 GHz. The 7623C Signal Studio for digital video can generate the fully coded DVB-S2 signal and use the receiver for BR or PR testing. The payload can be either TS file for subject video testing or data payload like all zeros or ones or PN sequence. For transmitter test, it needs a signal analyzer with RF frequency up to KUKA of V band. Keysight recommends the N1940B, N1930B, or N1921B, which can support the bandwidth up to 510 MHz and frequency up to 50 GHz. If you need higher RF frequency for waveband, you can select the N1942B UXA plus V3050A frequency extender, which can measure up to 110 GHz. For the modulation analysis software, Keysight provides either 89600 VSA with option 89601 AYAC can make the DVB-S2X with the preset, or use the N1954 EM0E VMA digital demodulation for DVB-S2 or DVB-S2X measurement. Now, let's see a quick demo for DVB-S2X component testing. Here, I use M9384B VXE and N1940B UXA together with software to demonstrate the DVB-S2X signal generation and analysis for component testing. Firstly, we need to open N7608C Signal Studio for custom modulation software and the Windows Program Launch menu, and then find Keysight Signal Studio Pro menu and select the custom modulation. Here it is 2021 version. Once the software is opened, select instrument. Here you can see I already choose the VXE M9384B. And then we need to configure the RF channel because VXE can have two channels as 1, 2. Here we choose channel 2. And adjust the frequency as 40 GHz and amplitude as 0 dBm. Under the waveform setup, we choose custom IQ For oversampling ratio, the default is 32, but here we can change it to 4 and minimum value is 2. Now click the custom IQ and then choose quick setup. Here you can see we have a lot of different standard presets, including DVB-S2 and DVB-S2X. Now select the DVB-S2X and you can see we have the predefined preset for DVB-S2X from 8 APSK to 256 APSK. Here we select 256 APSK with coding rate as 116, 180s. Then adjust the symbol rate as 400 microsymbols per second and filter alpha as 0.15. In the second window, you can see DVB-S2X signal is well configured with two segments. Segment 1 is a PL header segment with 90 symbols and modulation format as QPSK. Second segment is data segment with 2000 symbols and PL15 random data as payload and modulation formats as 256 APSK. The bottom windows shows you the whole DVB-S2X frame structure with PL header and data segments combined and total with 2019 symbols. Now click the download button in the top of the window. After some seconds, the waveform is calculated, then downloading and playing inside the M9384B we exit now. Then, let's analyze this DVB-S2X signal using the N9040B UXA together with N9054 EM0E VMA digital modulation software. Firstly, click on the window page tab. It will show you all of the mode measurement view that are licensed and available with this instrument. Here we scroll down in mode menu and choose the vector modulation analyzer. Then select digital demode from measurement menu. And lastly, select the dual segment from the view menu. Now we need to configure some demodulation parameters for this DVB-S2X signal. Press frequency and change it to 40 GHz. Press measure setup and settings, and then press optimize EVM to adjust the attenuator and IF gain to match the received signal power. Then press measure standard and preset to standard. Choose the digital video and then DVB-S2X. Now scroll down from the profiles and select the 256 APSK with code rate at 116, 180s. And press OK. Then press the demode menu and choose the symbol rate to 400 MHz and filter alpha as 1.015. Please remember to change the parameters for both segment 1 and segment 2. At the initial measurement, the results may not be good, but then we can turn on the equalizer to remove the distortion raised by the VXE and UXA. After a while, you can see EVM results for received DVB-S2X signal now is improved. Top left window shows you the spectrum at 40 GHz with span at 510 MHz. Top right window shows you the time domain waveform for the received DVB-S2X signal. The middle two windows, they show you the PL header segment constellation as QPSK and data segment constellation as 256 APSK. The bottom two windows show you the demodulation results of the two segments. You can see the RHO is about 0.99. That means the received DVB-S2X signal is well synchronized and the EVM is around 1.8% for the header segment and 0.7% for the data segment. Other results like magnitude error, phase error, function error, IQ offset, SNR quadrature error, gain balance results are also shown for both PL header and data segments individually. After the whole system is set up and calibrated, now you can connect your component and the test for DVB-S2X testing. Finally, let's see another quick demo for DVB-S2X receiver testing with N5182B MXG and N7623B Signal Studio for digital video. You can see I have launched Keysight N7623C Digital Video Signal Studio to generate the coded DVB-S2X signal. Firstly, choose the DVB-S2 or S2X and the format menu. Then, click the instrument node on the left window tree. Here, configure the frequency as 1.258 GHz, which is the frequency difference between DVB-S2X transponder and satellite RF signal. Then, set the amplitude as -50 dBm. Next, click the carrier mode. Here you can see all DVB-S2 or S2X related parameters, including modulation tab, code rate, rollout factor, symbol rate, via SNR header. Then you can specify the payload as you need. In N7623C software, it could be demo file, test pattern, zeros, ones, or PN sequence, or TS file provided by the customer themselves. Last, you can also add multipass symbol or frequency error as impairment testing. Now it's ready to generate and download the DVB-S2X signal into the connected Keysight X-Series signal generators. Then let's open the DVB-Stream software, which connects with a USB TV tuner as DVB-S2X receiver testing. Here we use the menu scan, in which we need to configure the satellite and transponder. And then we can set up the frequency, symbol rate, and modulation information, and some other parameters. Here we set them as auto, and then press the tune button. Then it can show you the two bars as signal strength and signal quality. Then press the scan button and it will show you the found channel as signal studio demo, which is previously generated by Keysight N7623C digital video software. Now you can see the demo bar on the screen, which means the video modulated as DVB-S2X now is well received by the TV tuner. This method is usually called subjective testing in digital video. You can adjust the power for sensitivity testing or adjust the parameters to make impairment testing. Thanks for watching this DVB-S2X introduction and test solution video. For more information, please visit www.keysight.com.